It's easy to add additional test steps to your test even when you're not in a record mode, as long as you've already captured the element you intend to create a test step for. Now keep in mind, you can always click on a test step and see the corresponding element highlighted in the element repository. So let's just say, for example, that I want to add a verification to make sure that this edit button shows up prior to clicking it. To do that, without actually being in the record mode, I can highlight the step that has this edit button originally captured with it, which in turn is highlighting the element for me too. We get confirmation by floating over that element that the images match with the images here. And from here, now that we've identified the element, we can actually use the step builder to create additional test steps for this element. So the verification I mentioned, let's say I want to place that just after this step two. So I'm going to place my recording marker in the position so that it automatically will fall after that and take place before the next one. I still have my edit button selected, but now I can go over here to verifications. And as you can see, there's all sorts of verification options here that I can choose from. So ultimately, I just want to make sure that this particular button is visible. And then I will just click Add Step. And as you can see, it's inserted a step for me into my test to verify the edit button is visible prior to clicking it. So these two steps use the same element. You can also, of course, right click on an element, go to Used By, and see also those two steps showing here. Keep in mind that test elements may be used across multiple tests and many steps as well. The centralized element repository manages all of that for you, makes it easy to change and update those elements on the fly. But the step builder is here for you to quickly and easily add additional steps. As you can see, many different options here for verifying those elements, as well as actions that you could see, very similar to the ones we saw on the element highlighter menu. Here you can see like clicking and text entry, mouse actions as well, scroll actions, JavaScript events too that you might fire on an element of choice. As well, you have a common menu which has many, many things in it, including one of our most popular features, test to step, that allows you to take tests, use them as subtests within other tests. So treating an entire test as a step within another test gives you a lot of capabilities. My parent test here that's using test to step for executing multiple subtests within that parent test. There's also many other options here, API test to step, opening a PDF, adding coded steps, clearing browser cache, execution delays, all sorts of different things that you can add into your tests that are pre-built, ready to go here. Also conditional logic for adding if-else scenarios, while loop scenarios, and loop options too. And even dialog handlers for uploads, downloads, logons, and so forth. Now keep in mind, these will naturally be recorded typically, but they're here so that you add those in additionally or modify them if need be. As an example, you could see this delete subtest actually has a while loop in it. Now, while loops do allow you to basically put steps inside of the loop or inside of an if branch or an else branch, and these are all driven by a verification. So we want to make sure that we have a verification there in the test. You can choose from the verifications that are in your test to generate that while statement or that if statement for each of those conditional logic options. And then, of course, you're going to drag and drop the steps that you want inside that loop to basically be completed as part of the loop process or the branch of that particular operation.